Good morning. Today I'm in the sacristy at St. Ignatius, and I'd like to reflect with you on the gospel for Friday of the first week of ordinary time. It's taken from Mark chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. When Jesus returned to Capernaum after some days, it became known that he was at home. Many gathered so that there was no longer room for them, not even around the door, and he preached the word to them. They came bringing to him a paralytic carried by four men. Unable to get near Jesus because of the crowd, they opened up the roof above him. After they had broken through, they let down the mat on which the paralytic was lying. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to him, "Child, your sins are forgiven." Now some of the scribes were sitting there asking themselves, why does this man speak that way? He is blaspheming. Who but God alone can forgive sins? Jesus immediately knew in his mind what they were thinking to themselves, and he said to them, "Why are you thinking such things in your hearts? Which is easier, to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise, pick up your mat, and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority to forgive sins on earth," he said to the paralytic, "I say to you, rise, pick up your mat, and go home." He rose, picked up his mat at once, and went away in the sight of everyone. They were all astounded and glorified God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. All week long, as we've begun ordinary time, we've seen how Jesus has begun to proclaim the kingdom of God. On Sunday, we remember that he was baptized by John in the River Jordan. The voice of the Father was heard, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." And the Spirit descended upon him like a dove. Jesus was truly God and truly man. When John the Baptist had been arrested, then we heard how Jesus began his public ministry proclaiming, "Repent, the kingdom of God is at hand." This was the time of fulfillment. Jesus wanted to bring people back to his Father. He wanted them to experience moments of his grace. And he inaugurated the kingdom, which he brought in his very person. And in inaugurating that kingdom, he was also saying, the kingdom of the devil will be beaten back, will be destroyed eventually. The coming of his kingdom would be the healing miracles and the exorcisms that Jesus would perform. But Jesus didn't want to simply proclaim the kingdom on his own. He also walked along the Sea of Galilee on the shore and saw Simon and his brother Andrew, and he said, called them, said, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." And they followed him. He walked a little further along and saw James and his brother John and their father Zebedee, and he called James and John, and they left their father in the boat and their nets, and they followed him. Jesus always wants to engage more and more people in his ministry. He went to the synagogue then in Capernaum, and he preached, and all were astonished at his word. And yet they also wondered, is he not the son of Joseph, the carpenter? They had very little faith. Nevertheless, while in the synagogue of Capernaum, Jesus saw a man there who had an unclean spirit, and he cast out that spirit from him. And the people were astonished at the marvelous authority with which he preached and taught, not as the scribes and Pharisees, but with a new authority. And he cast out demons. They said, even the demons obey him. What is this, a new authority? And clearly he was doing so with his authority as God. Truly God and truly man, Jesus then began performing many healing miracles, and many people were brought to him for healing. In yesterday's gospel, we heard how a leper approached him and said, "Lord, if you can make me clean, Lord, if you will it, you can make me clean." And Jesus said, "I do will it." And he made him clean. The leper did not ask to be healed entirely, but he asked to be made clean, to be made holy, body and soul. And his leprosy left him at once, and Jesus ordered him to go and show himself to the priest, according to Leviticus. And typically a leper would have to verify that the leprosy was gone, the priest would, and then they would offer a sacrifice of two doves. One would be actually sacrificed, and then the blood of the one that was sacrificed, a pure dove, a clean dove, would be dipped and would be set free. Jesus has come to bring glad tidings to the poor and bring liberty to captives, to set them free from sickness, illness, sin, and death. And today's gospel, which we just heard, then says, also teaches us that Jesus also wants his disciples to continue this ministry of mercy, to continue the proclamation of the kingdom. And so we hear this gospel of the paralytic being brought by his four friends who represent the church. This also represents how the church together must bring sinners back to God, back to Christ for forgiveness. They must have carried the man on a stretcher or on a pallet, and certainly in doing so, it must have been a long, hard road. Perhaps they didn't even have a stretcher, but rather carried him in a blanket, and this would have been very difficult across dusty roads or cobblestone, one step after another. And the man the paralytic must have thought, where are they taking me? Who is this Jesus? Is it really worth it? I will never walk again. But the friends of his never gave up on him. They had hope. They had already heard about the authority of Jesus. But then they saw the vast crowd all surrounding the house, and they thought, what are we going to do now? As must have the paralytic, we've come all this way and I can't get in. But they were creative. They went up on the roof. They took off the roof and lowered the man down for Jesus to heal. And sure enough, Jesus, just as yesterday his heart was moved with compassion, he also saw this man. He saw him as a child of God and addresses him as such. But the first thing he says to him, child, your sins are forgiven. Reconciliation with his father, for this he has come, to bring mercy so that a person might walk again and continue their spiritual journey. But when the scribes were doubting him and accusing Jesus of blaspheming, he said, so that you may believe, I say, rise, pick up your mat and walk. And he picks up his mat and walks. Imagine that, being able, like the leper, to go walk again, to go be with your family, to be able to work again, to be able to go up to the temple. What joy. And the crowds were astonished again. They were struck with awe and wonder at his authority and his power. And they glorified God, saying, we have never seen anything like this. Indeed, with Epiphany and the baptism of the Lord, the grace of God has appeared. It was a sudden appearance, but he truly appeared. God was made man, and with his authority, he brings mercy, forgiveness of sins, and new life. And that is what Jesus offers to each and every one of us. But he offers it to each and every one of us also through his church, represented by those four friends who brought the paralytic to Jesus. Let us ask the Lord to help us with his grace to be more like them, to be a church not only of the reconciled, that is of the forgiven, but a church that reconciles, brings others to know the mercy and love of God, so that all might praise and glorify God.